Can you all hear me? Are we okay on the Zoom? Welcome this beautiful morning. My name is Richard Bennett, and I'm the convener of this conference, which I hope turns out very well. We'll see how everything operates in terms of room attendance and Zoom attendance. For every person in the audience, there are four or five that are joining us by Zoom from all across the United States. We welcome you to this symposium today here on the campus of the Iowa Western Community College in this beautiful arts center here in the center of the campus. We are in for a treat for the next 2 days as we celebrate. And that's the term that we'd like to use throughout this conference, is to celebrate three major events that come together in a remarkable way. The first is the 175th anniversary of the Mormon Trail and the exodus of the Latter-day Saints from their home in Nauvoo, Illinois, across Iowa Territory in 1875, here to the Missouri River Valley. That will be one of our key themes. It will be the Mormon Trail and the discoveries that we're finding along the Mormon Trail, even as of yesterday in Crescent, Iowa, where we found some 22 more grave sites that had long been never discovered. And so one theme will be the celebration of that remarkable experience. Second will be the commemoration and the remembrance of the beginning of Council Bluffs, initially called Miller's Hollow, eventually Kanesville, and then in 1853 renamed its present Council Bluffs. That's a remarkable story in and of itself. And many of our scholars will be speaking today about the city of Council Bluffs, the history of Council Bluffs, the future of Council Bluffs. We're looking forward to those presentations. And third, of course, is that this happens to be the 175th anniversary of the great state of Iowa. So we're having some scholars joining us from Des Moines and elsewhere in the state, from the State Historical Society, professors of Iowa history. We'll be speaking on that theme about the great state of Iowa. We're even going to have some movie clips from The Music Man that will be on a little later on this afternoon. So you got to stay for that, folks. You got to make sure you get there because, as we like to say, as the movie says, you really ought to give Iowa a try. And that's what we're doing today. We're really going to give Iowa a try. This is a marvelous time to celebrate. We hope that you have a good time. Now, also with us today is Tim Jacob, who is the president of the Council Bluffs Stake of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, who, along with us at the Mormon Trail Center in Omaha, is co-sponsoring this conference, this symposium. And then we also have Mark Eckman, who is the executive director of the Council Bluffs Convention and Visitors Center. The city of Council Bluffs is collaborating with us in this symposium, and we'd like to have them say a few words before I do some housekeeping matters. So Mark, we'll turn it to you first, and then to President Jacob.
Thank you, Dick. Welcome, everyone. I'm here instead of Council Bluffs Mayor Matt Walsh, who is unable to join all of us here today because of his travel plans. But I know that Mayor Walsh would certainly want to welcome you warmly and sincerely to Council Bluffs if you're here in person. If you're participating virtually, he certainly want to welcome you as a part of this symposium. He and I both had conversations with Dick and Tim early on as this began to take shape, began to be organized, and we are very excited about the prospects of Council Bluffs hosting this noteworthy symposium. It is a pretty rare occasion to have three different anniversaries being observed in the same number of years here in Council Bluffs. As Dick has already mentioned, the 175th anniversary of the Mormon exodus across the state of Iowa, along with the 175th anniversary of the founding of Kanesville that later became Council Bluffs, and then of course the granting of statehood to Iowa back in December of 1846 by then President James K. Polk. Very noteworthy, and the fact that Council Bluffs is at the middle of that is not lost on any of us who promote, love, and try to extol all the benefits and great things about Council Bluffs. We feel very honored to have an opportunity to host this occasion. While Mayor Walsh is not here, he would certainly want to encourage you, all of you who are participating in person and are from outside of the area, to really get out and explore Council Bluffs, to go down to the 100 block of West Broadway, to grab a bite to eat, whether at lunch or dinner or any other occasion. Also to check out the Missouri River, where Tom Hannafin's River's Edge Park is located, and even a better view of the river is from the Bob Carey Pedestrian Bridge. Of course, we have the Les Hills that cuts through the middle of Council Bluffs, and Fairmount Park is a great place to be able to see all of the west side of Council Bluffs as you're looking into the distance to the Omaha skyline. There's so much to offer here and so many different things that you will have a chance to see if you get out a little bit. And if you don't have a chance, or if you are participating virtually, I invite you to take the opportunity as a follow-up to the symposium to come here and see some of the things that are going to be talked about in regards to Council Bluffs, the Mormon Trail, as well as the state of Iowa. We are celebrating that 175th anniversary. It doesn't seem possible. I was around working for the Iowa Tourism Office back when the sesquicentennial was observed back in 1996. The years are getting past me, but with all of that, I just want to echo what I know Mayor Walsh would have said, and that is to welcome you, to wish you well over the course of the next 2 days, and please to get out and see as much of Council Bluffs as you possibly can.
As Richard said, my name is President Tim Jacob, president of the Council Bluffs Iowa Stake of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. I oversee seven congregations in southwest Iowa and in north Omaha, which represent about 4,000 members of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. And we, like Mark and Richard, we are so grateful for all of you to come and participate, to learn about our history. On a personal note, I am here celebrating my own personal history. 175 years ago, my five great-grandfather, Norton Jacob, traveled the plains and settled here. And so there is a personal touch. When I was two, my parents brought me back here from Utah. So we backtracked a little bit, but I'm so grateful to be here to celebrate, to learn about personal history, religious history, and the history of the people in this area. So we look forward to a wonderful symposium and want to extend to you just the warmest welcome. Thank you.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Tim. Some housekeeping matters for the two-day conference. This is a unique conference in the sense that it's a double thematic. Shall we say that there are two sessions that are going on simultaneously? If you've got your program, and you should have got your program out in the registration desk, you'll see that some of the sessions are going to be here in this room, this wonderful concert hall. And the other session will be immediately across the aisle, the hall, over in what's called the Black Box Theater. And you can see the program that there are usually three speakers in each session, and with a moderator to begin. Moderator will welcome all, like we're doing here today, and then turn the time over to the three speakers. There's a couple of sessions that only have two speakers, but usually three. And we're going to ask the moderators to welcome everyone, just like we're doing here, and above all, to keep everybody on time. If anybody goes over the time limit, we have a BB gun right underneath here that we can use. Be careful of your time, because as I said, for every one of you that's here, we have three or four or five, we have hundreds that are joining us virtually, and they're watching their time and are conference technologies folks need to make sure that we end on time so that the next sessions start on time. I do want to thank conference technologies, and that's Adam in the background over there. If you want to wave your hand, Adam. The technology to be able to take all these conference sessions simultaneously by room and by Zoom is a real challenge. And I know we're going to have some hiccups, so please be patient with us. So long as my session's fine, I'm okay. Everybody else, we'll see how that works. But seriously, we have wonderful technicians who are helping us with that. So, as time permits, we'll have questions and answers at the end of each session. Each session is about an hour and 15 minutes. And then that'll give time for three speakers and then also some time, hopefully, for questions. We'll see how that goes. Now, it's important to understand that all the proceedings are being recorded. We have not yet received permission from all of our speakers yet to have that publicly disseminated, so that won't be publicly disseminated, but we'll have a copy here, and we'll hopefully be getting permission from all the speakers later to be able to promote and publicize those. But they will be recorded for future purposes. And we want to thank all of our speakers. We have some 48 speakers who are coming and who've worked very, very hard to make this a successful conference. And we want to thank each one of you. Some of you have come 1,000 miles or more to join us this morning. And to our video audience, thank you for joining us. We hope that you'll be able to join now. To the video folks, those who are joining by Zoom, note that you have two links. You have a link to the concert hall, and there's a link to the Black Box Theater. And you can go back and forth from place to place during the conference. So all you video folks, you can do that by watching your program. We've sent out programs to you all. You should all have that. If not, please give me a telephone call, and then we can get you registered. At the end of this morning's sessions, we'll be having lunch. That is going to be right here on campus. To have lunch here is quite significant in the sense that it's going to be a barbecue picnic just out the back door over here and down the sidewalk about a football field's distance, maybe not that far. There'll be a tent, and there'll be barbecue, hamburgers, and what have you. In the program, presenters and panelists, you have a lunch pass. All of the rest of us, it's a modest fee of about $8 to $10 for lunch today. And they're going to be down there around noon, 12:15. We invite all of you to go to lunch then, because you won't have time to go down to town to Council Bluffs in order to get back here for the next session. So that will be going on today at lunch this evening. There will be a dinner only for presenters, which will be in the cafeteria of the Student Center right here on campus. Please feel free to ask questions. We'll do the best that we can to answer those virtual questions through chat, hear questions live. And now, we are in the midst of COVID. We cannot require wearing of masks. We encourage that, but it's not a requirement. We no longer even here have social distancing in the theaters. Up until about a month or two ago, that was all social distance. Now that's not required, but we encourage you to be wise in the wearing of masks and social distancing. So I think without any further ado, We will now just take a 10-minute break for you to get yourself oriented, see where the Black Box Theater is, if you don't know where that is. Mark off in your programs where you want to be. You can be going back and forth so that you can attend either of the sessions that are going on simultaneously, even after one speaker. If you feel, well, I want to go over to the other side and pick that up, feel free to do that as you move from place to place. So we're thankful that you're here. We look forward to having a good conference together, and enjoy. Thank you.